Good morning, everyone. Today, I explain about the subject of precursor concrete. Take any problem, how to calculate the pre-stressed to calculate the maximum working stress in concrete. See this example for problem, how to calculate the density of concrete, calculate the maximum working stress in concrete. See the problem, the rectangular concrete beam of cross section 30 centimeters deep and 20 centimeters wide is pre-stressed by means of 15 wires of 5 diameter of mm, 5 mm diameter are located at 6.5 centimeters from bottom of the beam, and 3 wires of 5 mm diameter are located at 2.5 centimeters from top. Assuming the pre-stressing stress in steel is 840 newton per mm square. Calculate the stress at the extreme fiber of mid-span of cross section. When the beam supports its own weight over a span of 6 meters and carrying an EDL of 6 kN per meter, evaluate the maximum working stress in concrete. The density of concrete is 24 kN per meter cube. Taking into account the given data, rectangular concrete beam, that means a pre-stressed concrete beam, the cross section 30 centimeters deep, that means 30 meters depth, and 20 centimeters wide, that means width, is pre-stressed by means of 15 wires of, that means 15 wires of 5 mm diameters are located at 6.5 centimeters from bottom of the beam. See this picture. This is the rectangular cross section of the beam. These are the 15 diameter of 5 mm and 5 mm diameter. And locate, this is the depth of 6.5 centimeters from the top, from the bottom, and a top 3 wires, 5 mm diameter at the depth of 2.5 centimeters located. This is the diagram for cross-sectional pre-stressed concrete beam. Given at a cross-sectional area, that means 30 centimeters into, this is at 30 centimeters, this is the 20 centimeters width of beam and depth of beam, 30 centimeters by 20 centimeters. Deep 30 centimeters convert to mm, 300 mm. Wide 20 centimeters convert to mm, 400 mm. Stress in steel, given the problem, 840 newton per mm square. Stress in steel, 840 newton per mm square. 15 bars of 5 mm diameter from 6.5 centimeters to 15 bars of 5 mm diameter from 6.5 centimeters centimeters top 3 divides of 5 mm diameter 2.5 centimeters from. See, this is a small correction for this is the bottom, 15 wires is the bottom. See this diagram problem, 15 wires of 5 mm diameter are located at the 6.5 centimeter from bottom. This is the bottom, this is small correction. 15 wires are bottom, the 3 wires are top. Is only given UDL load 6 kilonewton per meter. Length of this span 6 meter. Just like this is the. See this picture. This is a simply supported beam precessor component acting on the load liable for 16 kilonewton per meter, and the span is 6 meters. Go to next slide. See this. Distance of we calculate the centroidal distance for rectangular section y given the formula. See this formula. 15 into 6.5 centimeters. So it we can convert to the 65 mm. 15 into 65 plus 3 into 275. This is the remaining 300 minus 65. That is 275. 15 bars of 65. Plus 3 bars into 275 divided by 15 plus 3. Total number of wires give the y value 100 mm. Centroidal force from the base y equal to 100 mm. Eccentricity equal to half of the depth divided by 2 minus y. 4 on left 300 by 2 minus 100, so eccentricity equal to 50 mm to calculate the eccentricity. This diagram, horizontal rectangular cross section of this diagram, they calculate the centroidal distance and calculate the eccentricity from distance acting on the some eccentricity c equal to 50 mm and y centroidal distance 100 mm. E by a, that means stress is given to 840 newton per mm square for tensile stress. P can P equal to 840 into cross sectional area. A goes to equal to P by A equal to 840 newton per mm square. P equal to 840 into capital A, that means cross section area. 840 area is total number of bars 18. Total wires 15 plus 3 18 into 5 by 4 diameter 5 volt square. P equal to 206.88 kilonewtons. This is the cross sectional area. P is calculating for load. Load will be calculated. Area of cross section equal to 200 into 300, that means 60,000 mm square cross sectional area. Section modulus Z, I by A, BD cube by 12, Y means Y by 2, that means BD square by 6. Z value for rectangular section, BD square by 6. That means Z equal to 3 into 10 power of 6 mm cube. Next, self-weight for net load. That means symbol is mg. That means net load. You know the dimensions of rectangular beam, 0.2 into 0.2. They convert the meter into unit weight of concrete, 24 kilonewton per meter cube. Mg load, the live load, net load, W square by 8, that means movement. Movement for dead load. Mg means movement for dead load. W square by 8, W is 1.44 kilonewton into L means span 6 meters. 6 square by 8, total moment 6.48 kilonewton meter. Mg equal to converts the Newton mm. 6.48 into 10 power of 6 newton mm. This is the calculation of sulfate for sulfate or dead load moment. This is the process and calculate live load MQ, WL squared by 8, movement MQ, movement at that live load, 27 kilonewton meter. How to got the 27 kilonewton meter value? W means WL squared by 8, W means 6 kilonewton per meter. Live load is given 6 kilonewton per meter, and 6 is the length of this span. And I calculate this value, the live load already given. Live load, see this picture, 6 kilonewton per meter. This is due to uniformly distributed load. 6 into 6, 6 whole square. Length square means 6 whole square divided by 8. That means live load moment equal to 27 kilonewton per meter. That converts the Newton mm, 27 into 10 power of 6 Newton mm. Due to direct load, E by A, that means load by area. Direct stress, that means direct load, B by A, 4.94 Newton per mm square. You know the value of load, P value, or you know the cross sectional area, area, P load by area due to the direct stress due to 4.94 Newton per mm square. Directly approximates taken into 5 Newton per mm square. P by A, that means stress value, direct stress due to eccentricity load. P by Z, Z means section modulus, the already calculated BD square by 6. Z value. This is the BD square by 6, 200 into 300 whole square by 6, the value 310 power of 6 mm cube. Modulus of section modulus, Newton mm cube. You substitute this value E by Z for eccentric load due to eccentric load, 296.88 into 10 power of 6 into 50 divided by 3 into 10 power of 6, 4.94 Newton per mm square. PE by Z also 5 Newton per mm square. Resultant stress per dead load. Resultant stress per live load. Resultant stress per dead load equal to moment of dead load divided by section modulus. You give the resultant stress 2.16 Newton per mm square. And resultant stress for live load, moment of live load divided by Z, 2.27 10 power of 6 divided by 3 into 10 power of 6. To calculate the value, 9 Newton per mm square. See this picture, totally direct stress. P by A, Newton per mm square, P by Z, 5 Newton per mm square. Due to dead load, 2.16 Newton per mm square. Due to live load movement, 9 Newton per mm square. Total resultant stress calculated for totally. See this diagram. Upward got positive, downward give the stress. This is the stress diagrams for rectangular faces concrete beam. 5 plus 5, 10. 10 give this values, resultant stress. P by A and the 5 Newton per mm square, P by Z 5 Newton per mm square. Dead load live load for give the 9 plus 2.16, that means totally 11.16, and take in this account for these values, minus this 1.16 Newton per mm square. This is the calculation of our resultant stresses for dead load and resultant stresses for live load. Give this values for calculating the resultant stresses. This is the 10 Newton per mm square. Totally add for direct stress. 5 plus 5, 10, 10 plus 2.1, 12.16 plus the plus 9, totally 21 point, means 21.16. Resultant stress U plus value, dead load plus live load. For calculating the dead load plus live load, 11.16, remaining these values 0. 5 Newton per mm square, 5 Newton per mm square 0. This means calculate the direct values. 11.16 minus 10. This is the values minus 10. You give that 1.16 Newton per mm square. This is the resultant stress. Live load for live load plus the dead load, resultant values, resultant stresses. This formula will be calculated. This is the process of series diagram. Sorry, this series formula how to calculate the these values for top P by A minus P E by Z. A by Z, T for Z, T for top, about top, and another formula. Give the formula P by Z T plus M MG by Z MG by Z T plus MQ by Z T. P by A, you know, the stress 5 minus P by Z T 5 plus 2.16 plus 9, total 11.16 meter per mm square. From bottom, P by A plus PE by ZP, ZB means bottom of modulus, section modulus, minus MG by ZP minus MQ by ZP, that equal to 5 plus 5 minus 2.16 minus 9, that equal to minus 1.16 Newton per mm square. View these values, this process. This is the rectangular direct stress. Give the P by A, PE by Z. Another one, this is the stress diagram for dead load moment. This is the moment for MQ means live load moment. Totally, that equal to total resultant stress is given this diagram. Top fiber and bottom fiber. Top fiber 11.16 Newton per mm square. Bottom fiber 1.16 Newton per mm square. This is the problem to calculate the resultant stresses. For precious concrete member, take this formula for top, take this formula for bottom. P by A minus P E by Z, P by A minus P E by Z T plus MG by Z T plus MQ by Z T. This is the formula for top of fiber. Already know the values for top 5 Newton per mm square, PE by Z 5 Newton per mm square, MG 2.16 Newton per mm square. MG means MG by Z means that is the dead load movement, and divided by section modulus give the stress, top of the stress due to dead load, and MQ by Z. You know, this is the live load moment divided by section modulus give the resultant stress at top 9 Newton per mm square. These values of this formula substituted top fiber and bottom fiber, you know, to guard the stresses. This is the model. This is the calculating the resultant stresses, evaluate the working stresses of the rectangular precursor concrete beam. This is one type of model. Calculating resultant stresses. Again, see this problem. Take this given data, and calculate first the center total distance y equal to 15 into 65 plus 3, 275 divided by 15 plus 3 from base. The base y equal 100 mm. Central distance from base. Centricity equal formula half of the depth divided by 2 minus y. 300 divided by 2 minus 100 eccentricity 50 mm. P by A, tangent stresses give the problem, give the data. This is the pre-stressing steel is 40 Newton per mm scale. That is the pre-stressing steel. Stress is given 840. P by A equal to 840 Newton per mm square. P by A is nothing but stress. P equal to A cross-sectional area, 840 into cross-sectional area. That means capital A, 840 into cross-sectional area formula. See this number of, see this formula, cross-sectional area, N into pi by 4 D square. Number of bars, 18 pi by 4 into 5, diameter of the bar, 5 volt square, that equal to 353.42 into 2840. Give the load, total load, 296.88 kilonewtons. This is the calculation to calculate the load and area of cross section for pre-stressed concrete beam, 200 into 300. That is the area of cross section. This is the for a tensile steel area. This is the area for AST is nothing but tension zone, tension tensile stress. Give the for taking into account for calculating the load. This is cross sectional area for rectangular beam, 200 into 300, 60,000 mm square. Section modulus Z formula for rectangular sections, I by Y. I means BD cube by 12, Y means Y by 2. Half of the centroidal distance taking into account. Totally Z value is considered BD square by 6. B value know 200 and D value 300 whole square divided by 6. The section modulus is Z equal to 3 into 10 power of 6 mm cube. Well, get the another one, self weight of movement. That means the self weight of dead load movement, mg value, wl square by 8. You know the dead load, 0.2 into 0.3 into unit weight of concrete, it got the self weight 1.44 kilo per meter. Substitute to this formula, movement for dead load, 1.44 into 6 square by 8. Totally got the value 6.48 kilonewtons.